We end with an American teenager who has his own nuclear reactor. Steve Hartman ran into him on the road.
She's avoiding me.
You know how most high school boys only seem to think about one thing? Well, this kid is just like that.
I found the hot one.
It's just a different thing.
Oh my God.
17-year-old Taylor Wilson is into radioactive rocks.
When I hold something that's radioactive, it's kind of a indescribable feeling. It's kind of like when I'm with my girlfriend.
A little scary. A teenager handling radiation with his shoes untied. But the levels are safe, and there's really never been any reason for concern until he decided to build his own reactor.
I was going to produce nuclear fusion.
But what made you think you could even do this?
That's my personality. I think I can do things. There's nothing that's impossible to me. You can ask my parents.
Yeah, he's just not wired like we are.
Taylor's dad, Ken, is a Coca-Cola bottler. Tiffany, a stay-at-home mom.
Yeah, yeah.
They say Taylor started reading about nuclear physics in fifth grade. In sixth grade, he gave an hour-long science fair presentation on the subject.
Technetium-99m.
It soared over everyone.
Is an isotope of technetium.
Steve, I have no clue what he was talking about.
Yet they still let him try and build a nuclear reactor in their garage.
Yeah. Sounds like we're not good parents.
Yeah, it kind of does.
He's pretty much convinced us he knows what he's doing.
He eventually convinced the University of Nevada, Reno physics department, too.
Going underground.
They let Taylor move his project into their basement. And it was here, at the age of 14, that Taylor Wilson became the youngest person on Earth to create fusion.
You want to actually make a star? You want to crank this thing up?
He unlocked the secrets that drive the sun.
Okay, we have fusion.
Before he could drive.
Wow.
3 years later, he's now a senior at the nearby Davidson Academy for profoundly gifted students.
Obviously, Taylor could go to any college he wants, but would he get anything out of even the graduate level nuclear physics class, especially since he taught that class last semester? That's why he may go straight to pursuing his next modest goal of keeping us all safe.
Taylor recently invented a new way to scan shipping containers for nuclear material.
It's incredibly cheap, and because it's incredibly cheap, it can be deployed all over the U.S. and all over the world, creating first, second, and third lines of defense all over.
That's in addition to the cancer cure he's working on, and God knows what else.
Oh, I have hundreds of ideas. I have too many ideas for a lifetime.
Fortunately, he's got a really good head start. Steve Hartman on the road in Reno, Nevada.